Hello, you're watching Proactive London. BATM Advanced Communications has just announced that it's contributing $4 million to a $10 million follow-up investment in Ador Diagnostics, which will increase its stake in the associate to 37.21%. Joining me with more detail is Dr. Zvi Marom. He's the CEO of BATM. Zvi, good to speak with you today.
Good to see you.
So Zvi, maybe start by telling us a little bit more about Ador and what it does.
Yes. Ador was established about 6 years ago after a theory that was introduced by Professor Mike Heller of California and San Diego 20 years ago, into which the Americans VCs have put nearly $500 million, and it failed. And the idea was to create a system that can analyze in a very short time infectious diseases cause, whether it's a specific virus, a specific microbe, or a specific fungi, and give you the diagnosis in a very short time, something like half an hour, which has enormous advantage in cases like meningitis, sepsis, hospital admission, and also in cases that, for example, you want to start treatment of tuberculosis, you might know within half an hour which specific mutant you are dealing with and to which antibiotics it is a resistant, which has a very big value. This troubled many scientists, and a lot of money was poured in. We got it after lots of escapades in basically 2015. We demanded, in order to solve the problems, the 50% of the shares, and we created an international team in Germany, Italy, Israel, United States, and also with the help of Imperial College and the Liverpool School of Tropical Diseases, some professors there, Shevin Jacob and others, in order to create such a system. And now, after lots of hard work of several universities and ourselves, we are sitting with a situation that we have prototypes that are working, that we did the clinical testing and it works. And as a result of that, we decided the partners to put in an extra $10 million, believing that the next round will be done by big banks or big financial institutions.
Okay, so we're talking about the NatLab molecular diagnostics platform here that Ador has developed. How significant is this for the company?
Well, you know, first thing that I ask myself as a CEO is what I'm doing valuable to society. That's first thing first. And after, is it important to the company? Is it a real challenge for our scientists? And then how much money we will make? And the answer to all the three is excellent. Simple, excellent. There is no such system exist in the world. We will unveil it officially in the Milken Conference in May this year, assuming that there will be no pandemic hurdles, and very, very reputable guests have already been invited. Several universities, as I mentioned, are participating. So from point of view of diagnostic, it has the potential of changing the way that you diagnose people. I can show you what does it mean. Here you see the cartridge. It's internal. You put a sample of body fluid inside that, whether blood, urine, sputum, depends what you are looking for. You close it, you can't deal with that anymore. And then you slide it into the NatLab that looks like a video recorder. And with a protocol, which is isothermal versus PCR, that is the common one done today, in 30 minutes, you will get an answer, not a general answer, yes, COVID, no COVID. But for example, if we are testing respiratory, it will tell you, for example, you have a pneumonia caused by cryptococcus or whatever, immune resistant to this and that antibiotic. So that will give an immediate indication to the doctor how to start to treat you. It's a major, major problem that it takes time between you are visiting the doctor and you are starting a treatment. All the diagnostic in between takes a lot of time. This system knows to work in laboratories, but also in point of care. Very, very flexible system based on artificial intelligence. We have tested the software of the artificial intelligence. So we have a system that diagnoses in a different way. Already we have lots of interested parties. So in due course, not tomorrow, but in 2-3 years to come, it will be also a source of revenue. And there is no doubt that the big boys will be looking very carefully on it, because it gives a kind of dimensions that doesn't exist today. So from every aspect, we feel good with this innovation.
So how does Ador plan to spend that $10 million that it's raised from you and the other funders?
Well, the CEO had an idea to buy a Furket to his wife and run away, but I vetoed it as the chairman. So if we take the part, we have to do a few things. One, we have to increase our clinical studies. I have to say that some of them are financed by third parties, like StopTB and the Heidelberg University for tuberculosis, others for other things. We have to continue and to develop more panels. At the moment, we develop respiratory, we develop meningitis, but we are developing several other panels. We have cooperation now with several universities. We want to forge it better. We have agreements, but we want more. And last but not least, we have already tens of patents. We want to register more. We are now in the process of registering more, especially in the US. And we have just built two new molecular biology laboratories, one in Israel and one in Rome in Italy, in our campus in Italy, which are state of the art. And we want to prepare them for pre-production, which we are doing. And for this, we will need approximately $10 million. So this is what we are doing. We could easily raise it from third parties, but we decided, because of several indications, including future valuation, etc., that we will use the money of the partners, which all of them are well-financed and so on. So we prefer to do the round ourselves without getting diluted.
Zvi, how soon before this becomes a commercial clinical solution? Do you have a timeline for that?
Yes. In the third quarter of this year, we are testing our isothermal protocol, which is called RCA, on existing equipment in laboratories, which will give the existing equipment a much higher performance. This will be test number one that will take this year, but it will start to have commercial implications. Next year, middle next year, we are starting to put machines in several reputable universities. This will not bring us money, but this will make the system commercially viable. So by the end of 2023, 2024, we will start to see stream of revenue. I have to say that already we have big interest, we have serious interest from several big boys that want to look and to see if they can cooperate with us, assuming that the system will be commercially available. So I don't know which way we will do the distribution. BATM have a long history of working with big partners like IBM, 3M, Sun Microsystems, Arm, and Vodafone, several others. And it has been a way that we didn't have our own big sales force, but normally we had a support mechanism to support big guys that were going with our stuff to the market, some of it under our own name, some of it under OEM, and so on and so on. So we will see. First thing first, we want to put it in places with a lot of reputation, already registered, and see how it works with the caution that is needed in medical products.
I hope you'll keep us updated on any progress you make, but thank you very much for the update today.
Thank you.